Good morning, children. How are you? Hope you're fit and fine at your home, children. Isn't it? Yes. I hope you all must be fit and fine at your home. Children, do you remember in the last session, I've taught you about chapter number 6, The Throne of Justice, part 1. Before I start, I would just like to throw a light on what I have taught in the last session. In the last session, I have taught you about a cowherd boy who used to sit on the mound and he used to give the decision. When the king saw this, the king thought that there is some magical mound. The child who is just 10 to 12 years old, he used to give a nice decision. The king ordered his soldiers to dig the ground and find out about the magical mound. They found that a black magnificent black throne was under the mound, and that was King Vikramaditya's throne. The throne was taken to the palace, and when the king was supposed to seat himself on the throne, then the voice appeared of a Garuda that, wait, you doesn't deserve, please wait, he told, and just watch yourself, do you deserve the honor of sitting on the throne? The king thought that I should do 3 days fast. After doing 3 days fast, again, he was supposed to seat himself on the throne. Then second Garuda appeared. The same thing happened. Then the third Garuda appeared. Again, same thing happened. Again, the Garuda asked him a question. Do you deserve the honor of sitting on the throne? Like this, 23 times happened. Now, it was the turn of 24th Garuda. Now I'm going to explain about 24th Garuda. As he spoke, there was a loud rustling sound. Suddenly, to the great astonishment of the assembled crowd, the large black marble throne rose in the air and flew out with the Garudas holding it. The crowds watched amazed. Now what happened? When the 24th Garuda opened its mouth to speak, then he told that you have not been worthy to the people. You were unjust. You were cruel to the people and you doesn't deserve the honor of sitting on the throne. Then suddenly a loud rustling voice was heard and suddenly the throne of King Vikramaditya flew in the air, and the throne was held by the 24 Garudas. People were surprised, people were shocked to see the throne flying in the air. And the crowd who had been gathered in the palace, they saw that the throne was going up in the air. Then the whole crowd were amazed, shocked, they were wondered to see the scene. In the next slide, children, you can see a scene. You can see the scene that the throne flying in the air. This is the throne of King Vikramaditya and 24 Garudas holding the King Vikramaditya's throne, and it was flying in the air. The people were shocked to see this. I was not worthy to do so because of my faults, but I learned something from the Garudas, something that has changed my life. Now, the king, in front of the audience, he said, you know that I have done the false, I have done the fast, but still I was not worthy to do so because of my faults. He understood that he has made false, and he told to the audience that the words of Garudas has really changed my life. The lesson I learned is this: just sitting on Vikramaditya's throne was not going to make me a wise and just ruler. Now he understood his fault. He told that the Garudas had taught me a lesson. The Garudas told me that just sitting on the throne is not enough. You have to be solemn, you have to be stern, and you have to be worthy towards your work. And the justice you do should be fair. Now the king accepted his mistake. He told that the Garudas has taught me a lesson, that simply sitting on the seat will not make me a wise king. I should be wise and just in everything. all the time, whether or not I am seated on the throne of Vikramaditya. Now he understood the whole thing. He said to his audience that just simply sitting on the throne will not help me. Now Garudas have taught me a good lesson that I should be good in all my work. I should give proper justice to the people. And as I understood my whatever faults I have made in my life, and now I am going to improve myself. Whether or not I am seated on the throne of Vikramaditya. With this, the king moved away slowly. Once again, the judgment of Vikramaditya had been a wise one. Now the king understood the Garuda's words. He said that, now I understood what Garudas want to say. Garuda, the 24th Garuda, had taught me a new lesson. He said that, now I am going to change myself. And my life has been completely changed. Now I'm going to improve myself. Before sitting on the throne, I should be fair. I should never be inhuman to the people. And he understood that Garudas had taught me a good lesson. At the last two lines, it is said that, again, King Vikramaditya's seat has taught us a lesson that our heart should be pure. The king understood that before sitting on the King Vikramaditya, our heart should be pure. And now I understood why the cowherd boy can give proper justice, because his heart was pure and he was worthy to sit on the throne of Vikramaditya. So children, I hope you must have understood the chapter. Now the king went to the space where the throne of Vikramaditya had stood a few moments ago. "My people," he said, his voice clear but sad, "you all have seen the happenings of the last few weeks. You all have heard the question and my replies to them." And now he saw the throne flying in the air. He was shocked, surprised, and then he told his people who have been gathered in the palace that, "You all have seen that how the throne flew in the air, because I was not worthy to the seat. I was unjust and I was not given proper justice to the people. You all have heard the question and my replies to them. The Garudas did not allow me to sit on the throne of Vikramaditya. I was not worthy to do so because of my faults." Now the king addressed to his people. He told that, "You all have seen what happened in the palace because I have not given proper justice to you. And because of this, the Garudas did not allow me to sit on the throne." Now children, we will move on to question and answers. Answer this question in a sentence or two. How was the judge different from his playmates? Now who is the judge here? The child, the cowherd child. The judge was solemn and thoughtful and took the game seriously. The child who was the judge, he was solemn and stern. He was thoughtful, and whatever decision he used to give was very wise. Why were the parents surprised at the judge's wisdom? The wisdom of the child was beyond his years. The parents were surprised at the judge's wisdom because the child was beyond his years. The knowledge the child was having was just as if the elder person used to give his decision. Now the third question, children. Describe the throne of Vikramaditya. The throne of Vikramaditya was magnificent black marble throne, and it was supported by 24 Garudas. The king fasted and prayed for 3 days. How did he think this would help? The king believed that fasting would be repayment for his mistakes in the past. The king believed that, "If I do fast for 3 days, and I think that would be the repayment of the mistakes that he has done. What lesson did the Garudas teach the king? The Garudas taught him that the throne would not make him a good king. He had to learn to be fair and just. The Garudas taught the king that simply sitting on the throne will not help him to become a good king. He has to be fair and just. His heart should be pure. He should give proper decision. He should never be inhuman to the people. So the Garudas taught him a lesson that simply sitting on the seat will not help him. He has to learn a lot how to be fair and just to the people. Second one, children. My brother and I usually get up late on Sunday. It's our day of rest. What is the meaning of usually, children? Usually means in the way that most often it happens. So I have used the word usually. Third one, children. Dash, our teacher, sings to us in class. We look forward to those rare days. I have chosen the word sometimes. Sometimes our teacher sings to us in class. We look forward to those rare days. Fourth one. What a swimmer he is. After "is" is an exclamation mark. I could dash swim that fast. I could never swim that fast. I have chosen the word never. Now the fifth one, children. The membership fee has to be paid. Dash, they send us a reminder at the end of every year so that we don't forget. Here I have chosen the word annually. What is the meaning of annually, children? Once in a year. So these are adverb of frequency. I have chosen the word never, often, usually, sometimes, annually. So these words are called adverb of frequency. Now, children, we will move on to the next exercise B. Complete these sentences with the correct words from the brackets. Two words are given here, children. We have to choose the correct word and fill in the blanks. I avoid all oily food. Every time I eat it, I get a headache. So the correct answer is every time. The library is next door, so we can even visit it. Two words are given here, every day and never. Every day is the correct answer. Every day if we want. Anu and Kiran are late to school again. They often, and the other word is for many weeks. The correct answer is often. They often get scolded for this. We like to buy our groceries from Good Time store. We have been doing this. Again, two words are given here. The correct answer is for many years. So children, here two words have been given. We have to choose the correct word and fill in the blanks. Now children, the next exercise. Rewrite the sentences using the hints and bracket. Now here, children, one hint is given to us. With that hint, we have to make a sentence. They found a solution to their problem after a long discussion. Now the third one, children. Gopi went on trial for theft in the mock court of the boys. We have to rewrite the sentence by using the word tried. I made a sentence. Gopi was tried for theft in the mock court of the boys. Now the fourth one, children. The police permitted him to leave the room after checking his identity card. We have to rewrite the sentence using permission. Rewrite using permission. I made a sentence. The police gave him the permission to leave the room after checking his identity card. Okay, now the fifth one, children. The way in which the boy judge punished the guilty surprised the people. Now here we have to use the word punishment. Rewrite using punishment. I made a sentence. The boy judge punishment surprised the boys. Here I made a sentence. The boys judge punishment surprised the boys. Here the children, and this in the bracket one word is given. With that one word we have to again rewrite the sentence. So I have written the sentence. Now children, see the next exercise B. Describe the situations using the words in brackets. Okay, now one word is given in the bracket. With that one word you have to make a sentence. The sentence is, you come home one day to find out that your parents have bought you a bicycle as a present. Now the word that is given in the bracket is amazed. What is the meaning of amazed, children? Amazed means surprise. Your parents have given you a surprise. Now you have to make a sentence with this one. I was amazed to see that my parents had bought a bicycle for me as a present. So I made a sentence with amazed. Okay, now the second one. You are late returning from school and your mother is very worried. Isn't it, children? When you go home little bit late, your parents or your mother get worried. She is waiting at the gate for you. She is waiting for you and she is anxious. Anxious means she is worried, she is afraid. She is waiting for you that my child, up till now she didn't return. Now with the word anxious, you have to make a sentence. My mother was very anxious when I returned late from school. Understood, children? My mother was very anxious when I returned late from school. The doctor is talking to the patient. He has a very serious expression on his face. The word that is given in the bracket is solemn. Solemn means, children, serious. The doctor had a very serious expression on his face. Now I made a sentence. The doctor had a very solemn expression on his face when he was talking to his patient. Your class is visiting the zoo. The teacher gave you a very strict warning and tells you not to wander away from the group. The word in the bracket is stern. Stern means, children, strict. And strict or well disciplined. Okay, now here you have to make a sentence. Your teacher have given a very stern warning that you have to be in the group only. You don't have to wander here and there. So the teacher gave a stern warning to you that you have to be in the group and not to wander away from the group. Now see, children, fifth one. Your friend cracks a joke. You smile because it is funny. The word is amused. Amuse means, children, to entertain. Okay, now I made a sentence. I made a sentence. I was amused when my friend cracks a joke. I was amused when my friend cracks a joke. Understood, children? Now here only the word that is given in the bracket, with that word you have to make a sentence. Read these words aloud. You will repeat at the back of me. Never, not, name, punish, again, alone, king, carving, bring, along, stronger, and dangle. I hope you all have repeated at the back of me, children. Okay, now the next one. Now listen and repeat these phrases. The words that are given, these are the phrases, children. And now you have to repeat at the back of me. A strong animal, a thin ring, a nice song, the king's nose, a young man, the north wing. So this is a speech practice, children. Only you have to listen and repeat the words. I hope, children, you must have understood the chapter as well as the exercise. Now I'm going to conclude my session. Till then, stay safe.